to eat with the mates.
You're 13? What are you doing?
I'm 13, Mom. I do what I want.
There's never been a marquee when it's shut down, eh?
Hi, guys.
Trust me, Daddy.
Let's get wasted. Yeah!
Nice party. Bro, where are the others?
They stayed home.
Let's go to the boat. Point.
I'm wasted. You alright?
Nah, mate.
Nino, Nino, Nino. Also, mate. Binge drinking. So today we're gonna make a presentation about binge drinking. So first of all, I'm gonna give a definition. So the NHS defines binge drinking as drinking lots of alcohol in a short space of time or drinking to get drunk. Because everybody is different, it's not easy to say exactly how many units count as binge drinking. But I can say that for boys, it's drinking more than 8% of alcohol, which means like 3 pints of beer. And for girls, it's different. It's like 6%, which means 2 big glasses of wine. So, and our target would be the teenager.
Okay, so there are many consequences to binge drinking. The short-term consequences are accidents, like car accidents, due to alcohol, putting yourself in a risky situation because you cannot assess how risky it is, unprotected sex, which is very common, loss of self-control, many go in ethyl-induced coma, there are some cases of short-term memory loss, and as always, dehydration.
Okay.
So now let's talk about the consequences in the long term. So it can have really damaging consequences like cirrhosis, cancer, diabetes, and high blood pressure.
So we have concentrated on the country, the UK, and here's some data we collected. So 28% of the population has a drinking problem, while 16% of the population is a worldwide average. 44% of girls in UK, which are 15 years old, have already been drunk once or twice, whilst only 39% of the 15-year-old boys. And this big number, 8,697, have been the alcohol-related deaths in 2014. So this has a big social cost. First of all, the clogged health system. So the A&E has too many patients for its capacity, which 70% are alcohol-related in the weekends. There are more or less 1 million admissions to the hospital yearly for alcohol-related things. The financial cost to the government is of £21 billion, of which 3.5 goes into the NHS, 11 billion go in the fighting alcohol-related crime, and 7.3 billion is lost in lost productivity and missed work days.
To conclude, we can propose some solution. So there's many solutions, but first of all, it's important to set a minimum unit price that is going to reduce alcohol-related harm and make sure that sellers make transactions with people that are over 18 years old. For example, the hospital admission rate increased for people that are between 15 years old and 24 by 57% from 2002 to 2010. So it's important to, I think, ban alcohol marketing, first of all in cinemas, in movies, and after, try to find something with the sport industry and the show business. But I think it's going to take more time.